two, three, four, five, roll six, speak in English, roll seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 30, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, first day, Vishal Kumar Singh. Yes. Next, 24. 25. 26. 27. Roll 28. Bhavana. 30. 31. Yes. Yes, please. To the discussions that we continued yesterday. Now you can just come to the comfortable place. We are continuing with the discussion, the portrait of a lady, class 11, chapter 1, the first book, that is Hornbill. Yes. Could you please give me the original book?
Yes.
Yes, please. Paragraph or on the top, that is fourth page number. May I read the first one? Listen. Her silver locks were scattered untidily over her puckered face. Ask the meaning of the word puckered. Puckered, yes. Puckered means wrinkled. P-U-C-K-E-R-E-D. What is the meaning of puckered?
Wrinkled.
Yeah. So now, wrinkled. W-R-I-N-K-L-E-D. Now you tell me, how was her, you know, white or silver locks? It refers to her hair. It refers to her hair. It got scattered untidily all over her face. The grandmother's, you know, silver hair,
yes,
silvery hair, got scattered all over her, I mean, head and face, untidily, just scattered. The scattered word always comes with the untidiness. It is totally untidy. Then you just see that another word, her lips constantly moved in an inaudible prayer. It's a beautiful word, inaudible. A monitor has been made, she can be a little big monitor today. Tell me, have you got a duster? At least clothes, and we often make it by adding prefix. You know, in class 10 and 9, you must have heard of prefix. A word which comes before another word to make another word. Listen, a meaningful word. Like if you add in before audible, it becomes inaudible. It becomes
inaudible.
And it is opposite of audible. What is the meaning of audible? I'm asking question. And is my voice audible? Are you able to hear my voice?
Yes.
If you are able to hear my voice, it is audible. If you are not able to hear my voice, it is inaudible. It is
inaudible.
So like that, tell me, what is the opposite of, how will you make opposite with legitimate? I'm writing the word. Another word it is legitimate. I'll tell you the meaning also. Akriti, legitimate. I want an opposite using a prefix. You have to use IN, illegitimate. 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 Legitimate. There will be double L. Illegitimate. Illegitimate. Illegitimate, you are writing like that. Tell me, legal.
Illegal.
Yes. This is illegal. I-L-L-E-G-L. Now you tell me, in illegal there is double L or only one L? Double L. Illegal. Like that you tell me, relevant. R-E-L-E-V-A-N-T. How to make it opposite? Irrelevant. 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 I-R. Irrelevant. I-R-R-E-L-E-V-A-N-T. Relevant, irrelevant. Relevant means meaningful. Irrelevant means meaningless. This means meaningless. Legitimate means legal, lawful, jayaz, and illegitimate means najayaz. Sometimes we call it a child, illegitimate child. That child is not legitimate, that is illegitimate. Now, similarly, yes, Khan, now what I was talking about, that the grandmother, you know, her locks of hair got scattered all over her face, and what about her lips? It went on moving constantly in an unaudible prayer. What did she do most of the time? Anybody please, Akriti, you have to speak, answer. Don't worry, you can speak in Hindi also. What did the grandmother do all the time? She prayed. She prayed by moving her lips in constant, intonation. Remember, she went on moving her lips constantly in unaudible prayer. The prayer was not audible to the people, but she went on moving her lips silently. That is what we call in an unaudible prayer. She went on singing the prayer of God, but that was not audible to the other people. Am I right? So say like that, the grandmother, so say all of you,
the grandmother moved her lips in an inaudible prayer.
She went on singing the prayer of God silently. So two things that happened side by side. What did she do? While her, you know, silvery hair, you know, it's got scattered over her face, she kept on moving her lips, in an inaudible prayer. Silently she went on praying to God. Constantly she prayed to God. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains. How has the grandmother been compared? She has been compared like the winter landscape in the mountains. Why? Ask sir, why? What is the relevance of this comparison? But in the mountain, what happened? When the mountain is covered with snow, it looks a snow-capped mountain. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
The grandmother is dressed in white, completely white.
Yes,
and over her white hair, she has got silvery, white face, she has got silvery hair. Silvery?
Yeah.
And all over her face, her silver locks are scattered. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So she is dressed in white and there is silvery, you know, hair scattered all over her face. It appears as if she is the winter landscape in the mountain. In the
mountain.
Very exactly. This similarity is quite relevant because of her appearance. Because of her
appearance.
Yeah, very good. Now, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. You can ask, sir, why has there been a reference of peace and serenity? Serenity means tranquility. I say,
yes, sir.
The grandmother is of course not pretty, but she is beautiful. Ask why, sir?
Why, sir?
She is beautiful in a peaceful way because there is a sign of, you know, tranquility and peace and contentment on her face. Uske chehre par bilkul santushti aur shanti dikh rahi hai. Kya dikh rahi hai? Boliye. So she is really beautiful. Maybe she is not physically pretty, but she is spiritually beautiful, because there is peace and tranquility reflected on her face, reflected on her
face.
And therefore we can say that she is really beautiful in totality because her face is full of tranquility, peace. Am I right?
Yes,
and that is why the grandmother has been called an epitome of peace and tranquility. An epitome of peace and tranquility. She is a statue of peace and tranquility. Peace and
tranquility.
So now we can say that the grandmother is in totality a woman who is dressed in spotless white dress. Spotless
white dress.
And the silvery hair which covers her face and what is scattered on her face makes her look like the winter landscape
in the mountain.
Winter landscape in the
mountain.
Now there's a question. Right. Just right. The question is there. Every program there's a question. Come on. Right. Right. Elucidate. Elucidate. Here's the question. Elucidate. Elucidate. Yeah. Elucidate the phrase. Elucidate the phrase. Not pretty. Not pretty. P-R-E-T-T-Y. Not pretty, but beautiful. Beautiful. With reference reference to the chapter. With reference to the chapter. Yeah, this is the question. Here is the question, and now we are going to start the answer. I shall wait. Definitely I shall wait. Elucidate the phrase knocker to the author. Put a comma.
Yes, sir.
The grandmother was not pretty but beautiful. To the author, the grandmother was not pretty but beautiful. But beautiful. Put a full stop. She was beautiful in a peaceful way. She was beautiful in a peaceful way. She was beautiful in a peaceful way. Put a full stop. He remembered her counting the beads of rosary untiring. He remembers her counting the beads, B-E-A-B-S, beads of rosary, R-O-S-A-R-Y. He remembers her counting the beads of rosary untiringly. The word is here, untiringly, T-I-R-I-N-G-L-Y. He remembers her counting the bits of rosary untiringly. Put a full stop. Her silver locks lay scattered. Her silver locks lay scattered. Her silver locks. Her silver locks lay scattered. S-C-A-T-T-E-R-E-D. Lay scattered. Her silver locks lay scattered. Untidy over her pearl and puckered face, P-U-C-K-E-R-E-D, puckered face. Put a full stop. Puckered face. Her lips moved constantly. Her lips moved constantly. Her lips moved constantly in an inaudible prayer. Her lips moved constantly in an inaudible prayer. Put a full stop. She was like the winter landscape. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains. She was like the winter. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains. Serene and content. Last word. Serene. S-E-R-E-N-E. Serene and content. Content. Serene and content. Okay. Chandan, you will come a small introduction of. As you have come in class 11, give us two lines experience of this 2 days class. How different is class 11 now from class 10? You give your two lines. You may speak in Hindi also. You are allowed. You have now been in class 11. What difference do you find in class 11 and 10? You can speak in Hindi also. Yes, yes. Try. Two to three words you must explain. First of all, you tell me, you have been in the same school. Do you really find any difference now? Yes or no? What difference do you find? In Hindi you can speak. I have told you, you can speak in Hindi also. Yes. Padhai achhi ho rahi. You are free. Kuch nahi. Aap English se bhi bol sakte, English bole to smartness badhega. Aur Hindi bhi bol sakte. What do you feel now? Aaj aapko kaisa lag raha 2 days ke baad? Because you have been in class 11 for at least 4-5 days, 1 week. How do you feel now?
I feel very nice because this class is very different.
Teaching is a little different. The responsibility of class 11 is also a little bit higher, am I right?
Yes, sir.
And the group is very good, am I right?
Yes.
Very good. You, what's your name?
Hansel.
It's good.
Yeah, look.